Hello, Gundam fans, this is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Hyakuri from Iron Blooded Orphans. So this is the other Taiwan's mobile suit, and definitely made for space. I don't think it could work in the atmosphere because they didn't bring it down. Maybe they just didn't want to. Although the fact that the character who pilots is using one of the other ones, the Hyakurin, which is actually rearmored, makes me think that, no, it's only for space. Maybe it couldn't. It'd be kind of funny if they brought it down and it just fell over because it was too back heavy. Kind of like the model, you can't have it standing without the stand it comes with because it just fall over. Because little feet? Yeah. It doesn't work. But I really do like the looks of it. It's got the weird little, it's like a really tiny head, but it looks okay encapsulated inside the backpack. Which is pretty much part of the model, because you have to actually connect it, the backpack, to the torso with these parts here. And if you take it off, you have like these pegs and flat parts, it just doesn't look good. And they did make some hydraulics in here that kind of go into cavities in the chest and in the thighs. The chest isn't too bad, the thighs are very easy to pull and just have them sticking out like that. And just has some stairs. Nothing on the head, thankfully. We got some. I got two on here on the circle. These four dark brown. The gray on the shoulders here. The light brown on the elbow, and also the elbow joint. And then you got. Wasn't there? Was that it? Huh. I was thinking there's something else, but maybe not. So, it's not a whole bunch of stickers, mostly, the ones I don't really care for are these ones on the elbows. It adds a little bit of color, and if it was the real gray, yeah, you could get away with more parts, but as it is, it's gotta be stickers. Not a big deal. I think the only panel lines are the legs, like seam lines, are right down there, and then they almost fix the leg down here, but it's a little too far off to the side, so you kinda have to remove that. This one you can get away with making a panel line, not so much here. So I kind of wish it was in the center, but oh well. Other than that, looking pretty good. They do have a nice panel line underneath, something you're not really going to see. So all in all, it's a very unique mobile suit, that's for sure. It certainly has the Justice or Infinite Justice feel, but without the ability to bring the backpack down to kind of help it stand, you have to use the stand, which, you know what, I'm alright with. Now, getting into that head is a little tricky, so you kind of just have to get your thumb in there and move it around some. Yeah, you can do it, just a little hard. These parts here can actually move up, so you can get the arms up. And out that far, there are ball joints at the shoulder. And they move forward. Or like it's nowadays moving up, but there's no point in moving up because you just sit here. So, they go forward. They can rotate below the shoulder. Double-jointed elbow, ball-jointed wrist. You got the ball-jointed waist. Like I said, these parts are tucked in, but if you're not careful, they'll easily come out of the cavities there. Oops. But you can get a decent range of motion without pulling those out. Now the legs. So the part that has the molded hydraulic is a swivel, and then the leg is ball-jointed. So if you don't care about that sticking out, it's a lot easier to move. But even with the hydraulic in there, we're really far forward, and as far back until it hits the backpack, and then out, and then you got a double jointed knee, and the feet. They can't go forward or back. They could go side to side until the armor came on. The lower legs are pretty much an inner frame, nothing else. And then the toes can go down for, like, space flight. And that is about it. So, you know, it's kind of weird. I personally, the hydraulics in the stomach, I'm not really sure what they could have done with to make them stay. But, I think the legs, the hydraulics should have been molded into the leg. And then they would have looked like they were connected to the waist. And if you pulled them out, they wouldn't look as bad as that, I don't think. So, yeah, whatever. It's not a huge deal. You can kind of fudge it and mess with some, but it does limit the leg going out if you don't want it to look weird. So, still, I think the articulation is alright for what this thing is. It's different. It's kind of weird, but it's not terrible. It's alright. Now, the Hyakuri comes with two guns, which are definitely unique for this mobile suit. And they do fit easily into the hand. You don't have to take the hand cover off, so that's good. And they look pretty good. But the cool thing is you can actually store them in the backpack with the arms inside. Now, but first, I want to show off these flaps, which actually cover the arms. These become shields, and you get a set of arm connectors. Now, they are actually different, so you have to make sure that it goes in a certain way, because there's a little groove in here, which will match the elbow here. It's kind of like the strike, in a way. It even kind of looks like the strike. So, just peg it in, and there you go. And it kind of works as like a melee weapon, because you can punch people with that, since it goes over the hand. Now you can have it, because there's a peg under here, you can have it on the side or underneath. I prefer the side, just because it allows you to easily hold the gun. So you can have the shields and the guns on at the same time. Now, having the arms stored into the backpack, let's get this part back on here. And the cool thing is, at least mine for now, it might loosen up over the years, but it's a very tight pack here. So you can actually use it like a hinge. And then the guns actually collapse. Now they're clipped in right here. So they unclip, and then open up here. And then you have the handles pulled up. And then the arms simply... Oops, I keep doing that. The arms fold into there, and then you just take the gun, put it back in the hand, hold your gun, come on, like that, and then close up, and there you go, all pegged in. Now, you can't do it without taking the gun out of the hand. I'm going to try it right now. I've done it before. So just straighten that up. Fold. Open up. Put the handle aside. Stop ripping the arms off. Yeah, these arms, like all the Iron Blood Orphans kits, the shoulders are very tight compared to the ball joints, I find. So bring that up. And there you go. Now they're connected to the backpack. And looking pretty cool. So I guess this is more like a high-speed flight. Less, resistance, I suppose? Now, that's pretty much all with the model that it comes with, but if you have the Iron-Blooded Arm set too, you can get the... Oops, well, I'm just pulling things off. That goes there. Goes there? Yeah, okay. Anywho, like I was saying, if you have the Iron Blooded Arm set too, you would get two of these little connectors. There we go. And they can be attached on the backpack. I just had to take out these. These are a little tight. Once you do it a couple times, it seems to get a little easier. But these can peg into the top. Now you can peg in one on either side, or because they're get like one for each edge, a different like different side. You can peg in one, both on one side, and then you can take the weapons that it came with in the set. The missile launcher, peg that in. Grenade launcher, peg that in. And now it has storage. And if you have the, if you have two of those Iron Blood Orphan sets, and you have one of the Hyakurins, you can always mount the other ones on the other side, because two of the weapons are compatible. So I do have another set of the Iron Blooded Arms too, And I'll take the knife, or long sword, whatever it was called, and the one of the guns, which the only one that has the connector port. And there we go. So now, the Hyakuri is now, like, kind of like a mobile weapons platform. So you can, like, fly by and take the weapons. Or could just use it itself, it doesn't matter. But I think it's kind of cool. Gives a little bit of a more functionality with other weapon sets. I think it's kind of cool. So those are the accessories. The ones it comes with are very nice. I love how they integrate into the model and you can use them as weapons and shields and stuff. And the pretty much fluid transformation with the arms. And then the use of the armor sets if you want to give it more weapons. So I think the accessories are pretty nice for this model. I don't think it needs any more. It has just what it needs. Now I figure they're just, oops, these arms popped off. Although I should have mentioned before I do a comparison that this stand, I already mentioned it comes with a set, the kit, but this little character is unique for this model. Because you could, like, technically take the just the stand and connect it into its butt, but this is for the backpack. It just gives it a little more height and allows it to stand straight. Which is how I'm going to display it. So, I'm going to compare it with the other mobile suit from Taiwiz, and that is the Hyakurin. And, you know what? They do look pretty good together. The Hyakuri is a little shorter, but, you know, has a huge backpack. But the proportions are kind of similar, at least in the legs. They have the thicker thighs, thinner legs, tiny feet. And then the bulky kind of shoulders with the thinner arms. And then the hydraulics are the similar. Although these ones don't move. So yeah, I really do like the Hyakuri. It is different, but I think in a good way. There's not much they can do with the backpack the way it was designed in the show. If it was designed to fold down, they could do that, but it wasn't. So I think what was done is pretty good. It still has quite a bit of articulation, albeit a little weird. And the accessories are really good, and the fact that it can work with the other sets is even better. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to USA Gundam Store. When you check out, in the discount section, type Prime 92 with a capital P. You'll save 5%. That's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.